Here's a coding interview problem from Amazon. We have an array of tuples or an array of arrays of two items each. This represents points on a two-dimensional space. So for example, this first item, -2, 4, represents this point right here because the x coordinate of this point is -2 and the y coordinate of this point is 4. And the problem is this. Given these points, how would you find the k closest points to the origin? And of course, the origin is at 0, 0. So for example, if the given k is 2, how would you find the two closest points to the origin out of these points? The two closest points here are -1, 0 and 0, -2. So you should be able to print these points and try solving this problem in a more general way. To practice, pause the video right here and think about how you would solve the problem and then come back to the video. The first natural step for solving this problem is to find the distance to each point from the origin. And of course, we can use the Pythagorean theorem to do that. So to find the distance to, for example, this point, -2, 4, we can just find the value of square root of -2² + 4² which is equal to square root of 4 + 16, which is square root of 20. So that's the distance from the origin to -2, 4. And we can go through the same procedure for every other point to find the distance for every other point as well. And after that, you can just construct a new array with objects containing the coordinates of each point, as well as the distance to each point from the origin. And this new array might look like this. I'm calling this new array points with D, as in points with distance. And the first object of this new array will correspond to the first item in the original array with the coordinates -2, 4 and with distance square root of 20, of course. And we're going to have the same type of object for every other point in the original points. So the length of points with D, the new array, will be the same as the length of the original array, points. And you can use dictionaries or hash tables to store this information instead of using objects as well. Once you have this array, all you need to do is you just need to find the k objects or the k points with the shortest distance. So at this point, this problem is actually equivalent to the problem of finding the k smallest elements in a given array of numbers. For example, if the given array is this array of integers, and if the given k is 3, we want to be able to find the three smallest items out of this array, which are 1, 2, and 0 right here. Now, there are a few different approaches for solving this problem. The simplest approach is the one in which you sort this array in an ascending order so that the smallest items come first, and out of the sorted array, take the k first items. And that approach would take big O of n log n in time if you use, for example, quick sort or merge sort. Another approach is using a variation of something called selection sort. And I'm not going to go into detail here in this video, but this approach would take big O of nk in time. Now, my personal favorite approach is the one in which we use a max heap. And this one would take big O of k plus n minus k times log k in time. Let me explain how it works. First of all, let's quickly go over what a heap is. In a sentence, it is an efficient way to keep track of the largest value in the given collection of numbers. Suppose, as an example, you're given these three numbers, 4, 1, and 5. If you construct a max heap with these three numbers, you can sort of visualize it as a bag or a box of these three numbers. And however many numbers you have in the max heap, retrieving the largest number out of it is very efficient. In fact, asking the heap what the largest number is without modifying the heap, so just examining what the number is without retrieving the number itself, will be done in big O of 1 in time. Now, there are a few other operations we're going to use on a heap for this particular problem. The first one is create. Creating a heap, a max heap, with k items takes big O of k in time. The second operation is replace. So for example, if we want to replace the current largest number in the given heap, this one, with a new number 3, then this heap will be rearranged so that the current largest number will be 4, and they will have 1 and 3 below it. This operation takes big O of log of k, where k is the number of items in the heap. And the third operation is print all. This prints all the items in a given heap in the order that's not necessarily sorted. So for example, this operation on this particular heap might print 4, 1, and 3. And this operation takes big O of k in time. Now, how can we use a max heap and those operations on it to find the k smallest items in a given array of numbers? Let's consider this array of numbers again, and let's say we want to find the 3 smallest items. Then the first step will be to construct a max heap with the first k items, or with the first 3 items. After that, for each item in the remainder of the array, ask ourselves, is this number smaller than the current largest number in the heap? If it is smaller, then replace it with the current largest number. So when we're examining this number right here, 2, the heap will look like this, and the current largest number has become 4. And when we're examining this number 3, 4 will be replaced with 3. We're going to keep going like that, and when we're examining this number 10, because this is not smaller than the current largest number in the max heap, we'll just ignore that number. And at the end of this process, just print all items from this heap, and we're done. We have the k smallest items from the given array. Now let's quickly recap our entire strategy using pseudocode. We're going to define our function closest, which takes the given points, and k for finding the k closest points to the origin. And from this function, we're not going to return anything, but we're going to print the k closest points. And in this function, first of all, using points, create points with d for points with distance, an array of objects containing the coordinates as well as the distance to each point from the origin. After that, using points with d, the array of objects, create a max heap with the first k items, and use the distance as the key when we create a max heap. And let's just call this max heap mh. After that, run a for loop for each point in the remainder of the array. And if this point's distance is less than the current max of mh, then replace mh's current max with p. And once we're done with this for loop, then just print all points in mh, and we're done. Now, what about time complexity? Let's think about it line by line. The first line here, using points, creating points with d, takes big O of n because we go through this array only once. And creating a max heap with k items, as we discussed earlier, takes big O of k in time. And here, we're running n minus k loops. In each loop, replacing mh's current max point with p takes big O of log of k. And so the runtime for this entire for loop will be big O of n minus k times log k in the worst case scenario. After that, printing all points in mh will take big O of k in time. So adding them all up, big O of n plus big O of k plus big O of n minus k times log of k plus big O of k, we're going to have big O of n plus n minus k times log k. And that would be the runtime for this entire solution. Okay, thanks a lot for watching this video. If you like this video, I would also recommend my course on Udemy, 11 Essential Coding Interview Questions, in which I cover 11 of the most essential coding interview questions to master with coding exercises in Python and Java. In case you're interested in taking the course, I put a discount code below in the description. All right, I'll see you in the next video.